The most disappointing thing about my 8-hour walk in New York City is the fact that my phone died a little after I got to Chinatown. I did know that video recording was going to be really taxing on the phone's battery, but still, I can't believe that my phone died that quickly. I had only walked for about 3.5 hours when my phone died. Thus, I'm left with no visual proof that I actually walked all the way up to the South Bronx that Sunday. You just have to trust me on my word that it was one hell of a walk. At around 12:30 p.m., around noontime, I took a brief lunch break on the benches placed near the City Hall buildings. I'm really glad I prepared a fairly hearty lunch of 2 veggie burritos and an orange, although I felt I ate too quickly. I felt full afterwards, but soon after taking the last bite, I was just wishing that somehow another veggie burrito would magically appear in front of me. The path I took on my walk were pretty straight and forward. I didn't zigzag to visit any landmarks that were important to me. I didn't feel the need to. Without the ability to video record, I didn't have that obligation. I mostly just stayed on First Avenue, and I just walked ever and ever towards Uptown. Along the way, I ran into another street fair, only this time it was on a much wider avenue. And at the very end of the street fair was a sizable set on which a rock band was playing some lively Spanish music, so there was kind of a concert going on. When I reached the concert stage, my toes began to hurt, not my legs. I know it's a little weird. I think it's because the socks I wore that day were too tightly worn over my feet. I don't know, but in any case, that was when I decided to veer off to the path to the right of me, finding myself sitting on a bench in an apartment complex. It may actually not be an apartment complex, but maybe a social services facility, probably for the elderly. It's on 12th Street on Avenue D. I think I've rested in that place before, maybe about 2 years ago when I was an intern at Housing Works, but I don't know, there was just that familiar air about that place that I couldn't quite put my finger on. I feel like I've been there before, and I feel like I know the place, but I have really no idea why or how. I only took 2 more short breaks after that break, one on 64th Street and then another one on 126th Street. Other than those quick 15-minute breaks, I was totally walking throughout the whole experience. Before reaching 34th Street, I was walking along the pier, taking the sight of the ocean separating Manhattan from New Jersey. It was a beautiful walk, and the day was great. Some of the areas that I walked past made me wish I like had a girlfriend or something, because there were a lot of, there are definitely a lot of romantic parts in New York City after all. The picturesque areas also would have been perfect for dog walking too, of course. The most exciting stuff occurred within my own mind, though. By the time I reached 64th Street, I realized that I chose the wrong pair of shoes for this walk. I decided to wear my favorite black shoes. They're very comfortable, but ultimately I learned the hard way that this pair is the heaviest out of all the shoes that I own, and I only own like 3 pairs. The weight of the shoes really worked against me as I struggled along Midtown New York. That's why I had to take a break at 64th Street. That was like a necessity. I needed to take a break. And I sat down on one of those little black posts that surround small trees. So on New York City sidewalks, there are trees. And they're small little trees. And around that tree is like a small little, tiny little fence. I don't want to call it a fence because it's like made out of metal. But I sat on that because there was no other place to sit. And, you know, just those short 15-minute breaks, just those short 15 minutes of sitting on that thing really helped me out. As I continued walking, my legs began to feel a bit sore again, but soon afterwards it was almost as if they had gone numb. I mean, that sounds awful, like numb? Does that mean like it was really painful? It's not what I mean. I mean, I can still feel the burn, so to speak, but I got into the natural rhythm of things, that the feeling was put in the back of my mind. I just began to take really big strides, like, oh, it's a little sore, but I'm just going to go for it, and I take bigger strides, and I walked at a really brisk pace. The exciting thing was there was all kinds of thoughts that bounced around my head, a number of which I do want to share like to the world maybe in the form of a YouTube video later on. You know, there's a lot of different thoughts that I had. Thus, you know, my journey all the way up to the South Bronx was mindless in the sense that I was giving absolutely no thought and feeling to the physical activity of walking up there. But at the same time, I was swimming amidst all these philosophical inquiries floating around and sinking in my head. Finally, at the 136th Street, I walked past an ad plastered on the building. It was an advertisement by Simply Orange, seducing me with a mouth-watering picture of a small bottle filled with 100% pure squeezed orange juice. I just salivated when I saw that, and that did me right in. After seeing that, I had to walk into the nearest deli and grab one of those orange juice bottles. And I have it right here. I drank it all. Simply orange, orange juice bottle. I had to get it. After seeing that ad, after that walk, I was just like, oh my god, that sounds so good. So, went to deli, and as I handed $1.50 to the clerk, I asked, you know, what time is it right now? Do you know? And his answer was 5:30. 5:30. So that was the end of my journey, right? Because my the goal of this journey was to walk 8 hours straight from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. When I got there, it was 5:30 on 136th Street. So I quickly took the bottle of orange juice, really elated, kind of excited. I had done it. I was able to walk from my apartment in Bushwick all the way to here, there on the 136th Street, past Manhattan, past Harlem. I know to many others out there who are used to like hard physical labor that this walk isn't much of an achievement, but when I walked out of that deli, I really felt like I accomplished something worthwhile. I took a big gulp out of that bottle of orange juice and headed towards the subway station located between 149th Street and 3rd Avenue. I know that subway is located there because I used to live right there. I used to live in the South Bronx, right around the area. So that subway station was about 10 more blocks away, but at that point, I didn't really care. I had done it. I was just ready to go home. So that was my 8-hour walk, and it really made me think about one thing in particular, and that is my aspirations in life, and this is kind of a serious talk. But as it turns out, I only have two big aspirations in life. Maybe I'll come to have more. Maybe I'll become a little bit more greedy about my aspirations further down my the road. Maybe have more ambitions or have more ambitious dreams. But right now, I tell myself that I'm only living for two things. First, I aspire to be an important part of like a nonprofit work that I really believe in, that I believe is needed. I mean, I don't need to be a key figurehead. I don't need to be a program manager or a director or a CEO or anything like that. I just want to be able to wake up every morning and feel that my existence is worth it. Not only to me, but also to the people and the animals I come to meet, and to this very environment that sustains me. As I said in my walk in one of my videos, I just feel the need to be needed. I mean, I need to be needed, to have an important role in helping others. That's something I really aspire to, and something that feels like years and years away from this point in my life, and that this walk just made me think about that aspiration. But my second aspiration that I came to think about is much more tied to this walk, and that is to become a parent. I want to plant a seed, and I want to witness the growth of that plant in its entirety, from its budding to its harvest. To be a great foster or adoptive father, that's one of my greatest aspirations. To be that, however, I need to take important steps. One thing I know for sure is that before I'm to become a parent of any human child, I need to raise and provide for like a companion animal, like a cat or a dog. Currently, I'm not ready even for taking care of a dog, much less an actual human child. So I want to take the necessary steps to get ready for that. And that's one big reason why I decided to do this walk. I really do want to become a dog walker because I feel that it's one tiny step closer to become a great caretaker. I'm still so young and I still have so much to learn and so many things to become ready for. I realize that achieving my aspirations will most likely take me many, many, many years, perhaps even some decades. But every step I take, I hope takes me closer to these two aspirations, and I hope that this 8-hour adventure was only a small beginning to something really wonderful.